I was recently talking to this woman at a party. She was waxing lyrical about her daughter. She's in high school, but, you know, she's reading at a university level, which is great. She's got a high IQ. She's probably going to be a future prime minister. Whatever. I'm so proud of my newborn, I know she's already going to be better than the prime minister. Because as opposed to all the prime ministers of the last 10 years, she actually went a full term.
The always funny Dave Thornton joins us now. And speaking of your kids, you've got two little ones now. How is that going?
Okay, well, I feel that stand-up bit's been time-stamped because, yeah, that newborn that I was talking about, she's now two and my eldest is four. And it's been interesting over the last 12 months being locked in with those two. I love them so much. Only recently, my four-year-old, she got out of the bath. She's obviously in the Nicky Nunas. And she ran up to me. And this is something we've been doing for the last 12 months because Daddy hasn't been making a lot of money, where fun in the Thornton household is just grabbing my kids by the ankles and hanging them upside down. That's a lot of cheap fun, that is. And she said, "Daddy, can you hang me upside down?" I said, "Yeah, right, mate." And I hung her upside down. And as I did, while her backside was in my face, and I'm so sorry I'm this blue early in the interview, she then farted in my face.
Classic comedic timing is what we say.
That's exactly what was it, Kate. Like, part of my brain was the parental brain, like, that's insulting, and the comedian part was like, "Wow, that's really good delivery. That is very good."
Now, Dave, you're gearing up to premiere your show Novel Problems at the Melbourne International Comedy Festival. On a scale of 1 to 10, just how excited are you that live gigs are finally back?
Live gigs are finally back because I've been doing Zooms, and I don't know if Claire Hooper's been doing Zoom gigs, but they are woeful. Like, there is nothing worse as a comedian. You're just staring at all these pixelated, apathetic faces of people.
You're not used to seeing your audience so close up, Thorno.
No. And, Kate, you don't know if they're wearing pants or not. Like, it's horrific. And I remember my first Zoom gig, guys. I was booked to do a 5:30 stand-up performance to an office. Obviously, in Melbourne, they needed a bit of a pick-me-up. But it was the end of their workday, and they're like, "Here, get on the Zoom and watch this comedian." And as I'm performing, I was watching the numbers of the Zoom group just go down. Like, people were just like, "I've got nothing but sheer boredom, and it's better than watching this peanut. Like, I have nothing to do."
Now, listen, you're very modest, Thorno, but you have just returned from touring Adelaide Fringe with a fellow funnyman piece of gold, Dilruk. What happened when the Double Ds hit Radelaide after they also were thirsty for comedy?
So we were in house quarantine for 22 hours a day, and then we'd leave to do our gig because we were doing half an hour each of an hour show. But the strange thing was, is I was living with Dilruk Jai Singer, who's a great comedian, and also living with the project's own Tommy Little.
Uh-oh. Now,
yeah, the thing is, Dil, right, he's on a big health kick. He's lost about 50-odd kilograms seriously in the last 4 years. Like, he's done an amazing job. And Tommy's Tommy. So I became mother hen, and I was booking all of our, like, Woolworths shopping online. And I said, "Guys, let me know what you want for breakfast and I'll book it online." And Dil's just like, "I want quinoa, I want kimchi, I want chicken breast." So I'm just living with Pete Evans right now. And I'm like, "Okay, this is happening." And I said, "Tommy, what do you want?" He goes, "Two slabs of beer."
I don't know how you've lived with Tommy Little and you still look so good. I saw you the other night and I'm like, how are you so healthy after the 12 months we just had? How did you stay motivated and fit whilst staying in your house with two small ones?
Well, the thing is, Claire, you can only see me from here up. From here down, it's been destruction. Like, I've got a colostomy bag because I've just been living with Tommy. But, mate, I mean, I kept fit because I turned 40 last year, so I'm just heading towards that middle-aged man. So I'm just riding around the mean streets of Melbourne, or at least I was for the last 12 months. And I've realised something. I don't judge people on the bikes that they're riding. I judge people on the equipment they're wearing while they're riding it. Because, like, I'm all for safety, but, you know, you see a guy and he's got the helmet and the fluoro cross vest and the flag out back and I'm like, what do you think, you're lost at sea? Like, what are you doing? But then when I see dudes in full high vis riding a bike, I'm like, ah, lost your license drink driving. All right, gotcha.
Well, head to our website for info on where you can get tickets for Dave Thornton's live shows. Hey, thanks for joining us, Thorno.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.
Hey there. Thanks for watching. Carrie loves to hear from viewers. Please forward your feedback to Carrie's email, perth.girl/21@hotmail.com, and be sure to subscribe. That wasn't Carrie you heard off screen.